Service here, back with another Rule the Wittery episode. We are playing as Pain, I mean Spain. Yeah. Well, immediately I'm going to go and build more corvettes because we're as a nation that has foreign station requirements. So I'm going to use that little bit of budget left just to build a couple more. So we're current... I've never played as the Spanish before in this game, and I've got a bit of a game plan to survive this time, because last time we had the problem of getting blockaded and then also not having enough ships. I'm going to mitigate that by going to war with a nation who can't blockade us. So that means that Italy, Austria-Hungary, France... Alright, which area are you in? You're in Northern Europe, aren't you? Shit. Sessions, Northern Europe. Yes. Okay, so... Turns out also that Britain and Germany are off the list. Well, Germany, maybe we can... So, nations I can go to war with and not be blockaded. America. Japan. And China. Of all those nations, it'd be Japan I want war with the most. Now, I'm setting up a spy ring in the nations I know are going to be technological leaders. Those things are too single. Okay, I'm going to get rid of one of them. Because, as you know me, I don't like using the... single 8-inch. More reductions already. My god. Alright, it's the German Berlin class. So while we're here, I want to design a light cruiser class, which it's immediately given me a 2.5-inch gun, many 3-inch gun design. So 4,500 tons is what I want out of this thing. Okay, maybe I could go a little bigger. 7. Will allow me to do 650. Messed up the design. You know what? I'll wait as well until we've got those guys off the lines. So that is our battleship. 2 single 12-inch guns, 2 11-inch guns, and then 5-inch guns. I'm sorry, but that heavy secondary battery is not allowed. It's the game rules. Extra Alfonso, 22. The Alfonso's the good-looking design. I will allow it. I will allow it. Thank you, Italy, for having docks that are not being used right now. Demand they release the ship. up tensions, which should hopefully up budget. Now, I don't want to up tensions with Italy, though. We'll take them up on the offer. Demand that the guilty be charged even at risk of a war. I only just need a last two turns. Two turns and then I can do some more stuff. Right. And then nothing else to piss off Italy. I don't want to piss off France until I've completed you. I don't want to piss off France at all. I don't want to piss off Austria-Hungary. I don't want to... I'm literally pissing off everyone I don't want to piss off. That's great. Oh, you want to build another one. Okay. They're so concerned they can do a disarmament conference. Two more turns, then I can resume the corvettes. Our relations with America have taken a turn for the worst. Right. Okay, you want something in the Mediterranean, well, a few things in the Mediterranean. Deny any involvement. Okay, so I will send... For Northern Europe, you, two of you, and you two, to the Mediterranean, and you'll be our token Mediterranean fleet. Oh no, no. I've got to take the prestige here. I can't lose those orders. God. Right, we've completed our battleships. This is one of the rare occasions where I think that a disarmament conference would be a benefit rather than a negative. I need more budget, but I... Right, that's it. That is... Right, I need to... next time there's a prestige option, just take the... Prestige, yeah, do that. Right, I'm no longer at risk of being fired yet. It's too early in this campaign to get fired. We need to at least go through episode 2 before I get fired. Right, I need to send more ships to the Mediterranean, it seems. So... send you guys over to the Med. Okay. ...13-inch guns, quality negative 2. Okay, I'm going to, in the spirit of good relations with other nations, reserve my entire fleet. In pursuit of good relations. Right. It's another one of the corvettes. Handle it quietly and discreetly. We need to not piss off Italy at all. Is best case scenario. Hold off for 10 turns would be the minimum scenario I want. Because any ship I have building with them by the time we go to war, if we go to war with Italy, will be taken captive by Italy. Okay, we've got new stuff for a light cruiser. Isla di Luzon class with YST engines, which gives us a better... Right, 5,000 tons, 22 knots. Yeah, Isla di Luzon, and I'm also going to do some preparations for raiding duties because I'm thinking that for us, raiding is going to be our way of effectively sinking enemy vessels. 18 knots. 2,500 tons, 4-inch guns. Yep, you're all good. No, 5-inch. Ship is overweight. 3,300 ton AMC, which I'm going to get two of them constructed as we can only have two during peacetime. Thank them for the offer, but we can't actually do it. Allow it for extra budget. Handle it quietly and discreetly. We're playing a risky game here. Place four of those in construction and then halt one. New docks are completed. Our new CA is coming out. A pro-British coup is taking place in Iceland. Tensions with everyone has gone to red. Not yet. Please. No, not yet. Not yet. We are not ready for a war. Okay, the AMCs are slower than expected. We will not take this anymore. These words will never be ignored. You want a battle, it's a war. How can I send? How can I? Oh God, we don't have enough ships to do that. Mr. Prime Minister person. Northern Europe. Send everyone from the Caribbean to Northern Europe as well. You know what? Screw it, we've got the new armored cruisers. It's war. It's war in the Mediterranean, so. Right, we have a foreign stations issue. Two foreign station. You move into the Mediterranean and you're set as a. We need trade protection vessels as well. Trade protection. Trade protection. And then you two head back to the Caribbean. Seeing as we have foreign stations that need to be covered. Okay, so convoy defense from let's accept it. This is going to be our first battle. It's most likely going to be against the battleship, knowing what the thing has said. Convoy force, you are set to disengage and run. Yeah, we'll leave whatever coastal batteries we've got for stuff in. We've got a vessel of Italian design, I've just realised. Well, yeah, we've got an Italian design vessel that, is going up against another Italian designed vessel. The design that I believe we took an updated variation of. I'm gonna say that for roleplay sort of things, that the Alfonso class which we got off Italy. Before, obviously, Italy woke up on the wrong side of the bed and decided, we want war! Italy, at least right now, isn't as disastrous as I thought it would be. Says that. It gets revealed when we go into the home screen that we're being blockaded. You never know, it could do. Might not do. Again, you never know. Usually these things say you never know until it's too late. Then again though, for them to blockade us, they're going to have to do it in both Northern Europe and the Mediterranean. Not just from the Mediterranean. That, I believe, is a positive of having a nation with home areas in two separate areas. Although it means as well that we're going to have to be careful because if any other ally comes in with them, we're screwed. I think I may want to stop my intel efforts against like Britain and stuff for a while. How about we slow down a bit, give our crews a bit of a rest. Engine crews, that is. Stokers exhausted. Stokers exhausted. Okay, well, stokers exhausted. That's on everyone. We'll just make our way into Feral. Then. And if the Italian ship wants to come down to play again, which it doesn't, no, it does that sometimes. Goes to save instead of... Okay. Cut intel effort there. You know, nah, don't. Hopefully this isn't a fleet-based battle. It is, isn't it? You know, I had my problems. It's a convoy defense and it's with battleships involved, so I know this is gonna not be a good fight for me. You know my previous thing with losing all my capital ships? Might have to be prepared for that again. Right. Heading northward for right now maybe actually be a good idea. So there's one of these things, and then there's a bunch of other stuff as well though. You know, you head up to support the others of that type. You guys are no longer a scouting unit, you are an independent unit. Go to line ahead formation, please. And you two, let's open up the taps. Open up the taps on the cruisers. Right, there's a separate ship over there. I'm hoping we can just go for that separate ship over there, which is immediately being proven of a no because it's because of what the current course of the enemy fleet is. Okay, so their Italia class is those things. This class is essentially a repeat but with 12-inch because Italy doesn't have 13-inch guns, and I'm going to presume that 13-inch gun ship they got was British built or something. Right. Out of arc. Low chance better than no chance. We hit one with a torpedo, although I don't think it was the one we expected. Out of arc, low chance. Let's go, and then you guys turn back. Then we'll bring in the Fernando. Okay, so I believe it's this one that took the torps. Considering the fact it's halted in place now. Yeah, I believe the torpedoes didn't hit the one we intended to hit. Well, it hit the one we were told was out of our arc. Is what I will say to that. Okay, so I want to lower our speed down because our stokers are getting exhausted. Now, we want to avoid the same weapon that we have employed to great success. AKA, we don't want to be torpedoed. So, right, what is actually the damage state of these cruisers before I decide to take an apport? Right, you have structural damage. You have structure and flooding. Seeing as I won't be able to detach one with the amount of damage it has, but I don't like it that we got flooding on her, I'm gonna send her back. I'm gonna say that we've had a good run with the cruisers at least, and we're now just going to last stand with the three dreads. Might as well just go down to our cruising speed scene as it's going to be no different to us anyway, whether or not we're at cruise speed or not. Okay, you guys take up that heading, which would bring you more on a course towards Palmer. Yeah, towards Palma without you having to avoid an island, well, a headland. Yeah, that's what something like this is called relative to an entire island. It's called a headland. Or if I'm remembering my geography class, which was something I did for my GCSEs, which so it's been over a year since I was last in a geography lesson. That's scary that it was like a year ago that I completed my GCSEs. Okay. Think it's time to cut losses. Attach you, and then you will be heading off to the port at a slower speed. You, Squad Max, go. Cut our losses while we can still cut them. Percent ammo. If I can have the Fernando, if I can have the Fernando just move along, I think I should be. Fernando, you're gonna have to take a long way home. And your long way home is heading to Barcelona. As I hear, Barcelona is quite sunny. No opposing ships in sight. We didn't lose a single battleship. That is great. Captain's mode victory points reduced, but that is great. We didn't lose a single ship. They failed their objective. We completed our objective and we sunk a battleship of theirs. And it wasn't sort of like those ship ones that we did in the Austro-Hungarian campaign. No. It's like those sort of somewhat decent pre-dreadnought ones. So yeah, we've got under construction a whole bunch of new Isla de Luzon class light cruisers. We are unable to challenge their forces there, if I am correct in saying that. You most likely are, but hell, at least Palmer is this way. Palma de Mallorca is that way. No, they can't be DDs. DDs haven't been invented yet. No, on the identification table. Sir, we've identified the targets. They're a type of ship that won't be invented for another few years. It's like, how do you even know that they're going to be invented in a few years? Well, you know, I was actually debating what nation to do this. Well, earlier today, like before I started, because I was thinking of doing America again just because I want to for whenever we have a budget problem of like, oh, Socialist Party wants to reduce budget. What's your response? I just want to be like, no, and then just play a Simpsons clip that I find really funny. It involves Mr. Bird, I'll mention that. It's like, this meeting is over, God bless the United States of America, and release the hounds. That would be like my responses if I play as the Americans to all of that, but I'd actually physically go and put on that clip. Alright, cut off this protected cruiser. Sink it while we have the ability to. We've been given the cover of darkness to help. The darkness have come to help. I believe in a thing called love, just listen to the roof of my heart. There's a chance we can make it now. We'll rock until the sun goes down. I believe in a thing called love. Ooh. Yeah, I haven't trained my higher range vocals in recent time. Like, there was sort of a period from when I found out I had sort of the vocal range I do, where I trained a bit with it, but then I just sort of stopped. Well, good news, everyone. We're not being killed yet. Entirely killed, I'll add to that front, but a fleet battle of only 3 armored cruisers and 1 of our battleships. Now, the armored cruisers, I've already got the plan here. Independent, line ahead, full speed, we're going to use the torpedoes. If we can find where their battleships are in this, which none of those are them, none of... Found where their they don't have a battleship here, unless it's over there. Yeah, it's over there. They're over there. So, my plan is, don't fire torpedoes. You've taken a whole bunch of damage, haven't you? Log entries, detaches due to move independently because of close enemy. Okay. You're detaching for that reason, right. You're currently on don't fire torpedoes. I'm gonna use that same trick I used last time, which I think I could still use because of the fact that I'm majority quicker than the battleships. Speaking of those KO Dulios, turns out that this reality is the same KO Dulio type. Right, okay. Caudillo, low chance of hitting, but do it. Low chance, but it could maybe go and get the Dulio. Right, you guys have done your duty. Well, what I'm calling your duty. I find it funny that I've been using the armored cruisers more like destroyers than armored cruisers. Right, everyone here, though, has done their duty for attacking ships and people. Your next job is get out. Get out while there is still a chance to get out. And hope that torpedo hit was enough to send Dulio down. With my knowledge of pre-dreadnoughts, it should have been enough to send her down to progressive flooding. Because unless they're bulged, they don't really have that great anti-flood. Yes. Everyone with availability to go into Barcelona is to go into Barcelona. So are the coastal forces, which are ordered to disengage. Yes. Okay, so the Dulio didn't go down. We lost an auxiliary, but we, in the end, got more out of it than they did. It's a marginal victory, but it's a victory regardless. Navy can fight on if needed. Is it just me, or am I having better luck in this campaign than I've had in all the others so far? I've noted that. I've been having more success here than I've had before, and that fucking bathroom door is just swinging mindlessly on its own. There's the Italian fleet. We're outnumbered 2-1. No, more than that. Baptized in fire 40-1. Oh, fuck me. I should stop with the Sabaton references, I know, but come on, who doesn't make a Sabaton reference whenever possible to make a Sabaton reference? A lot of people. Okay, so we're just going to do the gentlemanly thing and bring you into range of a coastal battery of 6-inch guns. What little that may do, but it'll help, I guess. Especially seeing as that horribly placed minefield isn't going to help us. Yeah, whoever placed the minefield like that, you're an idiot. I know for the lighter ships that coastal batteries can be a bit of a pain. No, you need to go heading 094. No, idiot, idiot, idiot. Actually thinking about it. Seeing as we're this close to Palma, so if literally anything like torpedo happens, I'm gonna take the risk. I'm gonna take the risk. We're gonna. We're gonna stay and fight for longer. Especially seeing as we have a coastal battery to help now. So it's set a battleship engagement. Oh, that's where the battleships are. Yeah, okay. So it turns out then that the cruiser force chased us all the way here and we're now getting reports from our coast watchers that the enemy battle fleet is actually closing in faster than I want it to actually, so fire. Oh, you've got a lot of torpedoes everywhere, it seems. Yep. You guys, Palmer is your next stop. Spain has no ships left at sea. It's a draw for us. It's a draw with us getting a slight bit less out of it, but it's a draw. Okay. Cruiser battle. Medium-sized. When they say cruiser battle, what they actually mean is armored cruisers being ambushed. Or would have been if I didn't have control of them at the start. Let's see, as I'm not using these for hearing the sound, gain sounds, I'm gonna drop them off. As I've already got working mic with the face cam. Like the literal only reason I use the face cam these days is because oh shit, I've just realized we've had most of our ships on reserve the entire time. The only reason I have the face cam is because it's got better quality mic on it than the other, than my headphones. Better quality mic is number one. Number two is about a year and a half ago, the idiot younger Silent had them plugged into his phone and tripped on the wire, and yeah, it now doesn't want to properly work unless I've got it in the input at a certain angle, and if it goes on that certain angle, it causes problems. So. Don't worry, I am slapping the bass. See, no picks. Oh yeah, I've just seen the composition of the enemy fleet, and my response is run into the Mediterranean. This riff was actually played on pick. Yeah, Italy won because of surviving merchants, so what? Unexpected fleet battle. Okay. What the hell are we doing here in this location? Okay, this is Operation GTFO. And if you need me to translate what I'm meaning by GTFO, because you've never heard that saying before, then I won't, because if you've never heard that saying before, then you're most probably someone who wouldn't want to be exposed to swear words. But then again, knowing the internet these days and stuff, you probably would have already have. I'm speaking as if I have younger viewers when no, I don't. Like, I'm being literally honest here. These days, I'm the youngest viewer who sees my videos. And I'm the one who creates them. Who reliably sees my videos, because apparently my younger brother likes watching these while he's colouring stuff. So Devin, if you're watching, you're my least favourite sibling. Don't think you're gonna get up on the list just because you watch my channel. You might as well just give up. There we go, message to my sibling who watches all these. Done and dusted with. Right, we got everyone in active fleet now. Okay, so we've got all our battleships and everything. At least it's in a more convenient area for a fleet battle. I will give it that. More convenient area just off of the Operation GTFO can be completed a lot more smoothly from this location. I will keep my battleships and I will charge them in just to at least give something of a fight to the Italians while essentially the battleships are sacrificing themselves to the lighter ships. Yes, I'm weird in that way of having battleships sacrifice themselves and lightships live. Full speed of fucking head. And, course up that way. Because we're most likely going to be surrounded. Well, if the AI is smart, they'll try and surround us. Hey now, hey now, don't dream it's over. Hey now, hey now, when the world comes in, they come to build a wall between us. You know, they won't win. Right. Off-topic singing of a Australian one-hit wonder song. Ow. Fuck. I should have really put the bass down. Ow. Ow. Note to self, never have a very solid piece of maple hit you in the shoulder, the elbow, I mean, not shoulder. Or I believe my bass guitar's neck is made out of maple. Looks like it. Quite a lot like it. So if it isn't made out of maple then I'd be like, oh, how did they get to make it look like maple then? Yep, everyone who wants to enter port can enter port. We are just going to murder off this one ship. Maybe more than that one, but hopefully more than that one I'll add, but just get that one and then go to port would be best off for me, because my ships are not expendable. Right, you took a torpedo. And detaching you, you're going to go your own way. You can go your own way, go your own way. You can call it another lonely day. That's Fleetwood Mac, for those of you who are uneducated in music. From the era of Fleetwood Mac, where Fleetwood Mac was ruined! Yes. Lindsey Buckingham and Stevie Nicks ruined Fleetwood Mac. You're not changing my mind on that one. They ruined Fleetwood Mac. Oh, God. This is like last time with, that battleship, it's going to have to take a longer way home just to avoid getting killed off by the Italian Navy, which is surrounding the remaining vessels. Or attempting to surround, I'll add. most likely succeeding as well. This is literally going to have to be our death ride in. So literally go in and get to the port now, or... which we did, just that for most of the ships. Now we just need to make sure that one of our vessels is able to get back as well, because to a port, most likely we're going to send her up to Barcelona, as she's hit and torpedoed hit, but her flooding is at zero, so she's not going to be given any more flotation damage. She's not on fire, so she's not going to be given structural damage. So my thinking is, as long as I don't send her above 10 knots, well, 9 in this case, because they can only go up to 9, okay, how come Italy got victory yet we sunk a... Oh, I've just realized stuff that I haven't done at all yet. Doctrine. Gunnery, night fighting. Apply, close. Right, I'm accelerating all those ships. I'm going to decline the battle. The Navy can fight on if needed. And the war ends. Okay. War ends. Most people are at peace again. I can normal construction pace these cruisers now. No more accelerating construction for us. Actually, everyone who can go on reserve, reserve. You active fleet, and then move you to the Caribbean, because we still need our ships in the Caribbean. Isla de Luzon class are coming along nicely, for the most part. We're going to have to make a couple of halting to the buildings for right now, but if I can at least get everyone less than 10 turns. I'm now fucking glad we ended the war when we did. Italy and Great Britain are an alliance now, and it was also France that allied themselves with Great Britain as well, so... holy shit, we're lucky. We're lucky there, chat. We're lucky. Right. Now, normally with content creators, this would be the best place to stop the episode on a high note, but I'm not like normal content creators. I still have PC time left. I am not going to stop yet. Okay, that's the training implemented. 10-inch. Yeah, let's get 10-inch guns. Hope for a turn. Resumption of construction. No. What was it? Gunboat. Send only a gunboat. So I'm thinking once we get these cruisers off the line, which should be soon. 6 turns. Well, it's going to be longer than that because I'm now going to have to halt, but we are not going to reduce our budget. This meeting is over. God bless the Spanish state and release the hounds. Right, the Joker mentioned some average ships. World economy's recovered after crisis. Our light cruiser is out. Our budget is in deficit. Of course, he wants 5 more cruisers. Right. I was going to spend our budget on destroyers, but it seems we need 5 more cruisers. Let's make a positive out of this. A 9,000 ton. Fast for us. Cruiser. You know what? No, if I'm gonna go fast, let's go with a light cruiser. There is freedom within, there is freedom without. Try to catch the deluge in a paper cup. Alright, so. Knots. Alright, I want that on a 6,000 ton hull. So, immediately, I'm going to reduce down to 5-inch guns. Although 6-inch as well, though, that's... Right. I'm going to go the 6-inch, but I'm going to forego the twin turrets. I'm gonna go 23, and then just hope that we get the special event. Gonna forgo casemate guns entirely. Six, 800. Yep. Right, 8,000 doesn't work. 9,000 tons is our maximum we can go. Crowd quarters. Oh god, we can't afford that. Valuation in 5 turns. Design. That guy? No. I know it wasn't Isla de Luzon. So that one? Yes. Yes, it was that one. $3,000 for that. Okay. Threatened by the Americans. I'm not going to use the Americans to build a... Open up you again, because I think I now finally have the allowance, a budget to... I can do it. Valuation in 2 turns, so I'm going to have to... Do no reworks. I'm gonna build 6 and then immediately get myself into trouble with our budgetary managers. Right, I can have 4 of you under construction. The rest of you halted. You guys didn't really do much. Scrap. Fuck, you're actually good. The 2 of you not on foreign station are going there. You're going nowhere. Yeah, the Argon class is actually good. You're the new one, so I can't mothball you guys. You're in home waters, mothball. Then mothball you 2 as well. Reserve everyone else. And to Maria Teresa. It's actually a good looking ship, but I'll be obviously. It's not in it's only going to be a turn. Two turns, but I'm gonna need a right. Seeming much praise, good, 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 good. Now we gotta halt everything. Fleet morale is